one. I was inspired to do this video the other day. I was at home drinking coffee and realized I could not remember the last time I went out to get coffee from where I was working. I was right up the road from Starbucks and would go there pretty regularly throughout the week or go to Dunkin' on my way to work, which adds up. So I've been saving money in the long run by making it at home. One of my favorite splurges when I go out to get coffee is caramel macchiato. I like getting the iced version, but I've figured out how to make one at home that tastes just like Starbucks or Dunkin' Donuts, so I'm going to share that with you. I'm using a Ninja coffee bar. Mia says hi. I looked it up because I'm basically making espresso, and Keurig has espresso pods that you can get. I know they're on Amazon. Or if you have a regular pot that you're using, just brew a very, very, very strong pot of coffee. The Ninja has different options. You can brew one cup, a travel cup, half a pot, or a full pot. I've made the one cup. They have classic brew. I never use that one. Rich brew, which is what I normally use like in the morning when I brew coffee, over ice option. Or the specialty brew, which is what this is. This is the specialty brew makes like an espresso. So I made one cup of the espresso with, I bought Kirkland coffee that's in my pantry right now, but I was making so much that I was like, I have to get the bulk to save money in the long run. So I do about 3 scoops, this size scoop, like hefty, like kind of go over the top a little bit for the one cup. So it's like super strong and it is hot. It's not, didn't come out cold, so we're going to dilute it so that we get more of the drink ahead of time instead of just dumping this in with the ice. So put some ice in here. I'm that kind of person that I love getting on Pinterest and seeing all the makeup dupes where people take like high-end products and do the research on like the drugstore brands that cost a lot less and are easier on your wallet, but work pretty well, not exactly the same, but some of those things, like you get a sample of it and you're like, why did I try this? I don't wanna spend $80 on this primer. But that's how with me with coffee is, like I was probably spending a lot per month. If I did that, I don't even wanna do the math. But this in the long run is saving so much money and it's still really good too. And I'm not lugging me around to different coffee shops every day. But I'm getting the ice melted here. In this cup, I have just ice cold milk. I use whole milk, but whatever you have on hand works. And I'm going to put some caramel flavor in the milk. The salted caramel is really, 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 really good. I don't add any sugar to it. To me, this is enough flavor in itself. I don't like it super sweet, but if you do like it sweet, I would say right when it comes out, put some sugar in so that it dissolves in the hot coffee and then ice the coffee down. But to me, this flavor flavoring syrup is sweet enough. So if you like it sweet, you can add sugar, whatever floats your boat. Gonna put some of that in there. Stir it up. You can try to, it's still not melted. Yeah. Did you hear Mia? She says hi. You can try to float it. Little bartending trick. Might not work. Doesn't look like it's working. It works easier with alcohol, but this is coffee. There is kind of a divide, but another sweetener that you can add to it that makes it a little like more of a treat is this Smucker's Sunday Syrup Caramel. I just put a little bit of that on there. I had it in my pantry one day. It was like, I wonder what that would taste like on there, because that's how Dunkin' does theirs and Starbucks too. So you put a little bit of that on there and mix it up.